Given the degree of escalation that is now continuously growing in the Middle East, it seems that neither Trump nor any other magician from any country will be able to solve the issue of the Russian-Ukrainian war, as well as other problems. Blinken warned of a possible Iran-Hezbollah attack on Israel. Axios warns about this and quotes him. Iran's attack on the Shiite group Hezbollah in Israel could begin in the next 24 or 48 hours. This time is already ticking, as Blinken made this statement a few hours earlier. The day before, Axios, citing its sources, also reported that Iran's proxies, Iran itself and Hezbollah itself, could launch an attack on Israel on April 5th. Axios wrote that this attack could be larger than the one on April 13th, when 300 airborne targets were actually launched at Israel. But thanks to the coordinated work of the United States, France, Britain, Israel itself, and its allies, we managed to repel this attack. Other sources, including the Jerusalem Post, suggest an attack on Israel might happen on August 12th to 13th. We'll see which forecast proves accurate. Blinken announced his warning in a communication with the G7 countries. He said the attack could begin on Monday, August 5th. He added that the form of the attack on Israel is unclear. Secretary of State said the U.S. is working to break the cycle of escalation by limiting Iranian and Hezbollah attacks and containing Israel's response. Blinken called on other foreign ministers to put diplomatic pressure on Iran, Lebanese Hezbollah, and Israel, in particular, to maintain maximum restraint. Diplomacy seems hardly compatible with these three countries and groups. One source present during the conversation said Blinken seemed disappointed when briefing ministers on recent negotiations with Israel about releasing hostages in Gaza and a ceasefire agreement. Blinken added that before the assassination of Hamas leader Tehrani, the White House felt close to a breakthrough in the agreements. The G7 expressed deep concern about rising tensions in the Middle East that could spark a broader conflict and called for de-escalation. Analysts at the Institute for the Study of War reported that Putin might exploit the situation to divert attention from increasing aid to us. However, this is unlikely to work since the aid has already been announced. We don't expect any new breakthrough packages that have not been passed before. We will also discuss how high the tension in the Middle East is now, whether Israel will not be left alone, and new opinion polls in the United States.